Hey guys, Paul with Diode Dynamics. Today we're talking about reliability testing of our SL1 LED headlight. Now we get questions all the time, like, aren't these bulbs gonna be too hot when they're sealed in the headlights? Or got a customer up in Alaska saying, won't it be too cold when it's freezing outside? Well, we have a machine here that we use to test for this. This is an extreme environmental chamber, and it's gonna go up from 85°C or 180°F all the way down to -40°C or -40°F. So when you ask us, won't this get too hot? We've already done the testing to confirm it won't. This is something called validation testing, and it's part of our engineering process here. We'll also come back and make sure our production samples and everything are sticking to that standard and that we don't have any long-term problems. Now, if you look inside here, you can see we've got a bulb set up there just running. Now, with LED bulbs, heat is the biggest enemy. Heat is why many bulbs fail. We have another video talking about the whole thermal design of LED bulbs I'd encourage you to check out. So we want to, first of all, make sure the LEDs aren't going to get too hot, so they lose output over time. Then we'll also install them inside of headlamps. You can see you've got a headlight sitting there as well, to make sure that even with reduced airflow, when it's sealed in a headlight, our bulbs will continue to work with no problem. Again, how do we know? Because we're doing the tests required. But when it comes to reliability, we don't stop there. There's two other important things to test for. All right, our next test that we do for everything is this vibration test. It's a little table here. You can hear it going. It's gonna vibrate the heck out of this headlight that's on here. We've got an SL1 plugged into it. And so when everything's mounted in the headlight, we wanna simulate that on-road use, the vibration, and make sure that all of our screws, fasteners, all, you know, everything holding it together is going to stay in place and not fall apart on the road. It's a big issue if you think about it. It's like, well, how bad can it be? You put a couple thousand miles on a vehicle, that's major vibration over and over and over. This is gonna go through a sweep, that's why it's changing frequencies. You can hear it's getting pretty slow now and really shaking this thing. Goes through a whole sweep that's prescribed by SAE testing, and that way we know it's gonna hold together as it's being used. All right, so the last test we do is an electrical test. Now, you might think it's just 9 to 16 volts on vehicles, and you can plug it into 12 volts, and that's fine. But in fact, with vehicle and automotive electrical systems, every time you turn the car on, you spin up the alternator, you turn off inductive loads like fans and that sort of thing. These can cause huge voltage spikes in the vehicle all the way up to 200 volts. Now, they're really fast, so it's not like plugging it into 200 volts. They're only milliseconds long, but this is what kills most LED bulbs. If you have a bulb that lasted for a year, year and a half, and then it failed, it's probably because it got hit with these voltage spikes over and over. And you can see this because you'll always have more failure of LED bulbs in license plate light applications, for example, where they're always turning on with the vehicle at the same time. So we can test this with specialized test equipment like this. This is a Schaffner interference generator for automotive electronics, specifically built for this test. And what this will do is output different voltage pulses. Some of them are really fast, just a couple milliseconds, and some of them are 10, 15 milliseconds. They're all pretty fast. We've got this set up to show you what that actually looks like. The blue line here is indicating a 0 volt level. We're coming along, running the bulb. As you can see, it's just running at 12 volts, but then it's gonna pulse in this test up to 60 volts. We're just hitting it over and over and over. So we've actually counted, and it's got a counter on here, just past 200 times we've pulsed just since I started talking. So by hitting it over and over and over with those voltage spikes, we can confirm that our engineers did the correct design and included the right components to resist against those spikes so that it'll keep lasting over time. And personally, this is the most important test to me. You can always determine if a bulb's gonna get too hot. You can always, you know, just see if something's gonna vibrate loose, but it's much harder to see this. So I'm glad we're able to do this testing here to ensure that our bulbs aren't gonna just last for 1 year or 2 years, but years and years down the road. So that's all the reliability testing we do for the SL1 bulb. I appreciate you checking it out. If you have questions about electrical testing for automotive applications or LED bulbs in general, give us a shout. Thanks for watching.